It was bound to happen, 'cause your heart is caving in.
Hey you, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. For today's video, I wanted to show you my winter beach ideas. Now, I did do these kind of off camera in my own time between Christmas and New Year. I just simply didn't have a good PC nearby to record it as a speed build. So instead, I'm just gonna tour the beaches and show you what I came up with. I do find winter designs for the beaches quite tricky, just because I don't really think every item fits during winter time. But that is mostly my opinion. I just, in the end, went for stuff that I think does look good, but still doesn't feel too summery. So yeah, let's get going and look at the beaches that I've designed. So first off, I did keep most of them quite simple. I do like to still have some plants on my beach, especially weeds, but I hate that they still spread. Or at least only the weeds do spread, and since I really love having them, I decided to close most of my beaches in with either this print, that is also really not linked down below, but I wrote the create the code in the description. I call this weathered brick, and I actually used another path that I have used on other parts of my island that I'm not sure what I called it. Maybe I called it the path snowy or the path ice. Again, it's in the description down below. And instead of pretending it is a frozen pond, I pretended it is just a pile of snow on the beaches. And these two parts then, yeah, created some interesting looks, but at the same time kept the weeds from spreading. And then I just, I decided to actually keep the palm trees. I thought about it for a long time if I wanted to have them on the beach, but without the height of these palm trees, I find it a bit not directly boring, but I don't know, it feels off. So I kept the palm trees, but I have shaken them all because I do think they look a tiny bit better without the coconuts on them. So yeah, that's kind of up to you. You can either keep the fruits on it. I would fully get if you don't want to shake them every day. But for the sake of this video, I did end up shaking them, and I did, of course, keep the palm trees around. And as for flowers, I decided to reuse the flowers that I have mostly used on my beaches. And that counts for more of the items as well. I've used these log benches multiple places and these garden lights. And if we continue, I did use a few of these cypress plants as well. I really love the swinging bench, so I placed one of them here with just a few decorations. It's kind of a viewing point, I guess. We can't really look to that side, but if you could, then I don't know, this might be a cozy space. And then in the back here, it is one of the bigger rocks. I really struggled to find something to place here, so in the end I decided to make it just a nice star gazing area, and it gave me a reason to use these beautiful items one more time. And to just, I know, make it feel a bit more natural, I placed these bamboo partitions in here just to kind of hide the stargazing area just a tad bit, but not fully. So yeah, those are a lot of the crafting items I kind of had stored in my storage, and I wanted to just give them a spot on the island because I don't like to sell them or throw them away or anything. So yeah, that was a nice way to reuse some of them. Now for this next area, it is kind of combined with my campsite. Again, this was an item I was thinking about for a long time if I really wanted to use it, because it feels like an item that belongs in summer, but at the same time, because these are made out of logs, it kind of felt like you would just leave them be for the whole year around. And then maybe for the winter you would remove the pillows, but I decided to just keep the pillows on it because then I didn't really need to recolor them, and I do like that little touch of blue. But yeah, if you want to feel it a bit more more winter-like, you could always remove the pillows by recoloring it to another color swatch. Going on here, we have used the same weathered brick again, of course, with some weeds and some flowers and the palm trees. Now here to the side is my new campsite, and for that I made this area in my last speed build. And it is just a nice area to sit by the bonfire. I didn't have enough room on land to place one, so I decided that I might as well use the beaches for it, then at least I have an excuse to fill some of the beaches up with something useful or aesthetic, I guess. And yeah, I also used a lot of these rock prints. I usually call them either small rocks or stepping stones. One or the other, I decided to write down in the description as well. Continuing through the bottom of my beaches. Here is actually another speed build that I did, or partially a speed build that I did. It's my cafe area, and in the speed build I showed off this little area where I reused some of the same benches that I used in front of my cafe. And I used a sauna heater just because, I don't know, it felt kind of cozy to have some kind of heating system outside. And to just use that excuse, I just extended it to this area as well. So it's just one big cafe area. Kind of counts as the same as the bonfire. I didn't have place to place so many benches on land, so I don't know, I just used the beaches and made some snow piles and some flowers, and yeah, now it kind of fits my island theme. It fits the idea that there is a cafe here, and it fills up my beaches as well, so it's kind of a win-win for me, at least. Continuing past my airport, here I did kind of something a bit for me again. I had all these items lying around in my storage, and I was like, I didn't really want to sell them, especially the chair. So I just made a lifeguard area anyways, because why wouldn't anybody be able to drown in the winter as well? Or maybe it's just standing here waiting for the summer season to start. Again, it's just a little fill up, and I do like how it looks. And then continuing over here, here's a bit more random stuff, I guess. It wouldn't really make any sense to have these springies right here for the kids to play right with near the water edge, but I don't know, I liked how it looked, and again, I wanted to use the items anyways. Which then continues on the last part of this part of the beach. And I just made some of my classical grill areas. I really like how these log tables with benches look together. And I placed down the grills because I had them laying around anyway. I kind of wish I could shut them down just so it would look like they weren't in use. But I don't know, they didn't seem to be doing anything when you click on them. So I don't know, you could turn them around or whatever. Or just don't use them at all. And maybe you have some other items that you like to use. You could have placed them rocks stool, I believe they're called, and place a picnic basket on it or anything else. Yeah, but I still like a picnic area on the beach. Then continuing over here, this is again a bit of a random area. I didn't really have that many teams going on, so I just continued. I placed maybe in total two of these sandcastles. If you noticed the one in the first area, I kind of thought they look cute, and I personally have built some sandcastles in the winter as well. It's cold, it's not recommendable, but you know, I don't know, it might still be here, and maybe someone had really fun building on. So again, using the items that I have that look good on the beach anyway. The same counts for this item that you get from the fishing tournaments. I do really like how it looks. It might be a bit unnatural, the spot, but I don't know. I had an empty spot, and that's what I ended up putting here. And then of course I had to use a couple of my puppy plushies, or whatever they were called. The ones that you get with Christmas. And yeah, I had kind of a dog park in mind, but at the same time I was just like, I didn't really want to commit to a totally big area for just a few dog items. So instead, there are just three little puppies visiting the beach. Again, those give some life to the beach without really, taking up any space or making it look very out of season or anything like that. And then I created another bonfire area over here, just a bit more cozy, I guess. I mean, again, it probably would look better in summer, but it functions in winter, so yeah, just a little cozy area over here. And I kept my pier nearly the same as it was from before, so just a fishing spot. I just removed the little fish in its bucket because, I kind of found it was a bit cruel to place a bucket with a fish, a tropical fish or a summer fish when there is definitely cold weather outside. So yeah, I could have just fished for a new fish, or yeah, it's kind of up to you. You could also place the steel button, the iron button, I don't know what it was called anymore, but yeah, buckets, any type of bucket could be placed here, but I apparently forgot to place one anyways. Then continuing up here, apparently the shells are starting to respawn again. Used some patterns to just fill up and make it a bit more interesting, because I didn't really have that many items in mind that I wanted to place. So to keep it simple, I just filled it up with pads. And then here I placed just two random rope fences with a volleyball as kind of a symbol that it is a volleyball, sand volleyball field or whatever. Yeah. You probably would play beach volleyball in the summer, but it doesn't mean it doesn't stand here during winter. It just isn't being used, maybe. Yeah. And then here is my lighthouse area. Again, I didn't do any changes to this area because I really liked how it ended up being when I did my summer beaches. And the color scheme still fitted all the designs I've been making now, so yeah, I kept it just the same way it was from before, and I still do like it. Going on from my lighthouse is again a bit of a random space. I also kept this I forgot what it was called, a garden fountain, something like it. You craft it yourself, but I had this one here for ages. The only thing different I did was again to place some few ice patches underneath it, just to make it a bit more interesting. And yeah, I really like how this item fits on these rocks. I have a rock like this, or yeah, flat surface like this on the other side, but it is too small to place this item on, so otherwise I would have placed one on the other side as well, but yeah, apparently that one was just a bit too narrow. And then I have a second little swinging bench over here. And then now we are actually closing in on the last part of my beaches, which is probably the most fun part of all the designs I've made today. And if you have seen the thumbnail or the beginning of the video, then yeah, here are the penguins. I did see, I guess, a picture of this the first time on Instagram. I have forgotten the user that shared it, I'm sorry. So I gave it a Google search and I found the creator code, at least for these penguins. And I have of course also written that one down below for you. And this is not a normal print, of course. This is a custom pro design, I guess. It's under the clothing and not under the normal prints, I guess. So it didn't take up any of my custom design spaces. So I was really happy to use this one. And it created at least something a bit more unique on my beaches. Now, of course, you can place this wherever you want on your island. So if you don't want to use it for your beaches, you can still use it somewhere else. But since I was really struggling to find something interesting and fun for the beaches, this is where it ended up going. And again, I used a few snow patches or ice patches. I used a lot of the rock items you can DIY, besides this one, that one you get from Gulliver. And a few flowers just to make it match the rest of the beaches and the waterfall features that are on the other side. So yeah, those are my winter designs this year around. I hope you liked these ideas, of course, and that you enjoyed this video. And if you did, then don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed yet, then also don't forget to click that and click the notification bell so you get notified whenever I post something new. And of course, it is also possible to follow me on Twitter and Instagram. For now, thank you so much for watching, and I do hope I see you next time. Bye bye. The dam is breaking in.